lies to any of their business. Again, I would understand if someone's going into work every day saying, hey, guess what? That story of Jesus, it's a fairy tale, don't believe it. Or hey, guess what? You should really have sex before marriage. Or you know what? You should probably be gay.
Making the rules clear, or maybe taking the rules a little too far, the Cincinnati Archdiocese is now spelling out what's expected of its teachers and what happens if the teachers don't play ball. WLWT News' John London is live for us tonight with a detailed look at the new moral clause being written into teacher contracts. John.
Well, Sheree, you start right at the top of the new teacher contracts where it now reads teacher minister contract, and where it was one line or two of a morals clause, you now have a clearly spelled out entire paragraph that you either agree to abide by or risk losing your job.
The new teacher contracts are 6 pages instead of 2, and the language of the morals clause has been expanded. Teachers will be required to refrain from any conduct or lifestyle that contradicts Catholic doctrine or morals. Improper use of social media, public support of or publicly living together outside marriage, same for sexual activity out of wedlock, public support of or homosexual lifestyle.
We found that a number of our teachers weren't really clear on what would be outside of Catholic teaching. So we consider this to be a favor to them. It's fairer to them.
The litany of explicit prohibitions goes on to include abortion, public support of or use of a surrogate mother, public support of or use of in vitro fertilization or artificial insemination.
The Archdiocese of Cincinnati has very clearly drawn a line in the sand with this. Very clearly.
Former English teacher Mike Morosky, who lost his job in the Catholic system by posting his support of same-sex marriage on his blog, fears a lot of the top talent might leave.
People are going to be hurt are the students at the end of the day. A lot of the teachers I'm thinking of that are homosexual or that are, living with someone of the opposite sex that are working in the schools now, they're some of the best teachers in the city. And if they have the ability to leave, I don't see how they could sign that.
Teachers at Catholic schools like Purcell Marion are being alerted to the changes today. The Archdiocese tells us its research shows many parents want a true Catholic identity.
You know, if some people find that they can't sign the contract in good conscience, we certainly respect their decision not to be a teacher in one of our schools.
And on the last page of the contract that you see here, teachers will be required to initial a section that reiterates the actions contrary to Catholic teaching. That's right before their signature, agreeing that no demand for remuneration may be made after the contract is terminated by either party. Reporting live, John London, WLWT News 5.
All right, John, thank you. You know, many dioceses around the country are reevaluating teacher contracts in light of lawsuits from employee firings.